Almighty and everlasting God. You and you alone is worthy to be praised. We come before you, God, bowing before you in the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Lord, at a memorial time like this, in which you raised from the dead, you have given us that opportunity, O God, as to accept and rejoice in your holy name.
Yes.
Father, what can we say? What can we do as to accept more gracious a privilege that we can have today as to gather in your hall and rejoice in your holy and wonderful. Nothing in your hands we bring about, but simply to your cross. Knowing that without anything of our own, you have sacrificed, O God. You have given your life for us. What can we give in return, O God? Or what you expect from us is a pure heart, clean hand, O Jesus. O Jesus, we offer this unto you, O God. Sanctify us, O God, in all our ways. Let it be comely before you, O God. We bow before you. Kings before you, bow before you. Our forefathers bow before you. They trusted in you, O God. With this same trust in you. Let us not have the way of our own, but let us rejoice in your way. O God, remind us ever being mindful, O God, of the peril of only waiting for us to make one slip, whether it be in thoughts or in words, but I ask you, encamper on us. Not just dwell, O God, but dwell in our hearts every day, every second of the day, O God. For we dare not make a slip, or we dare not slide. We dare not walk on our own, O God, because the road is dark. Jesus, your word is a light unto our footway. O God, shine that light upon us. Shine that light upon our heads, top of God, that all man will see that light. And glorify not us, but glorify you. You alone is worthy. When we go back in memorial and we understand the pain you suffered, O God, we rejoice in the stripes that you took for us, O God. But in those set stripes we are healed. Heal us, O God, today. All of those who leave our various homes to come together, O God, as to sup with us, to sup with you, O God. Examine us, O God. Let us not walk in our own integrity, O God. Examine our hearts. Move from bench to bench. From bench to bench. And anything you see that is unworthy in our hearts, O God, I ask you to rebuke it. Because holiness is coming before you. You accept that. And you said in the word, the same way you are holy, we can be holy. We must be holy. We will be holy. We promise it, God. Because you don't want us to dwell in this tabernacle of God. You want us to dwell in the tabernacle of our own hearts, in our homes, in our children's home hearts, in our children's hearts, oh God. We beg you. We beg you. Keep us, keep them in the hands of, in the hold of your hands. Pour unto us. Because the mortal prayer, before mortal prayer, is so subjected to the wrong thing. Sometimes you gaze in the wrong direction, turn us around. And everything that is planned against us, we ask you, God, turn it around for your good. Because this is why you died. Die that all of us, even those who are not here today, O God, even those who are in different congregations, if you want us, O God, to turn it around, O God, for them too. This is what you ask of us this week. Remember your saints, that is true. Remember your saints, remember your promise in your words, that the saints will rule. Oh God, I pray, we lift our souls, we bend up, we take the crowns of our head and we bow it before you. God could prepare so much for us of time that it's only you can make us ready, Lord Jesus.
Yeah.
You had done it yesterday. You had done it the day before.
Yeah.
And you can do it now. You are God, a God of the ancient times.
Mm-hmm.
You are still God. Thank you for Jesus. We thank you, God. We thank you for your only begotten Son who made that all our sacrifice for us. We thank you. We lift up our souls.
Glory.
We bend our heads. Yeah. Down on bended knees, we cry out for you, O Jesus. Heal us, Jesus. Heal us with your stripes.
Yes,
times of old, you bear that, O God. All of you suffer before all kings, oh God, you say not a word.
Mm-hmm.
Because your mind was bent on making that sacrifice.
That is correct. That is correct.
Help us, Jesus. But we understand. That we understand and not take for granted the privilege that you have granted us. In spite of our wrong way, you still, oh God, you still, oh God, grant us mercy.
Yes.
Let us understand. Let us understand through Jesus that he will not pour new wine into no old vessels.
No.
The vessels must be clean and made a vessel of honor and not remain a vessel of dishonor. Jesus, what I ask you of myself. All I want more, Jesus, of you. All I know is to understand you by the
Lord.
Give me the understanding of the scriptures as I peruse your scriptures with you.
Yes.
Give me the, I can't understand it all by myself. And then I pray the Spirit well in us to work with all of the people like that are here.
Because
all of us, I believe, are readers of the scripture. Let us not be selfish in understanding that you give us. We will pass that understanding unto even the unbelievers.
Yes.
That one day they will believe and turn in the promise. Jesus, what more can you do? What more can you give with us? You have taken all the mercy, you see, Jesus, and you pour it about. You take the enemy and put it below our feet, Jesus. Strong and our heads come.
Yeah.
Because you are God. And beside you, there is no other. There is never any other. And there will never be any other. As you talk to beside you, when you see our Father,
God in heaven,
holy is thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us
this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses. As we forgive those that trespass against us, lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom and the power
and the glory forever and ever.
And by extension, I lift up to you, God, the one who opened the mission of Jesus. Thank you, God, that he will be faithful and true always. Examine his heart, examine his soul, and clean him alive with God. Because we are all flesh and subject to the things of the flesh. Let him not mind the things of the flesh, but the things of the spirit. And thank you for your God.
Yes.
And join the congregation and thank you for them. But give us that food and that nourishment that will fill our soul.
Bless the Lord. We give God praise. Thank you, Brother John, for the extra. And God will have allowed you to praise God that it's running in the church. So we want to sing, and after we sing, Brother Mike will come and read the scripture lesson and probably keep the company of the others. We have a little bit of the lessons. So after the lesson has been read, we'll have one testimony. And today is a day I'm grateful to Almighty God, so somebody wants to have a powerful testimony. If you want to feel the heavenly breeze, go down in the valley and rest. If you want
which are separate. As I'm born into the household of faith, I greet you all in the most powerful, wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We just had our stay here. Today will be one of knowledge and one of power. We will read today's lesson and the greetings would have already gone online, and I just extend the same greetings towards everyone in the community. I trust that you will understand why we are here today. We wouldn't just take it as a formality to be here because people used to gather, but we'll pay greater appreciation for the purpose of which we are sent. That's you. Mark chapter 16 from verse 1. And when the Sabbath was passed, Mary Magdalene and Mary, the mother of James, and Salome had bought sweet spices that they might come and anoint him, that was Jesus. And very early in the morning, the first day of the week, they came unto the sepulchre at the rising of the sun. Very early, yeah? And they said among themselves, who shall roll away the stone from the door of the sepulchre? And when they looked, they saw that the stone was rolled away, for it was very great. And entering into the sepulchre, they saw a young man sitting on the side, clothed in a long white garment, and they were affrighted or afraid. And that word really didn't mean fear, it was amazed. That's the interpretation. And he said unto them, be ye not afraid, or be ye not affrighted. Ye seek Jesus of Nazareth, which was crucified. He is risen. He is not here. Behold the place where they laid him. But go your way and tell his disciples and Peter. I wonder why. special invitation, mother. That he goeth before you into Galilee. There shall he see him as he said unto you. And they went out quickly and fled from the sepulchre, for they trembled and were amazed. See how it comes out of the same amazed? Neither said they anything to any man, for they were afraid. Let us rest just there. We could continue to peruse the balance while we're talking if it's necessary. May God add his blessing to the reading of his word while we join together and say, glory be to the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, as well as in the beginning, none of us shall be, world without end.
Amen. Praise the Lord. I want to take time after that reading so that we could get that testimony. We welcome one testimony. Let's have that testimony this morning. With no testimony, we move on to a special song by. We have that testimony. Okay, well, then we have a special song by Sister. God bless you.
Good morning.
Good
morning. I'm happy to see everyone.
Good seeing to you.
Let all creations testify.
God is good. And his mercy is enduring forever. Praise the Lord. We are about to hear from the man of God, God's mouthpiece this morning. But just before, I just want to make a little observation. And that observation is that I spoke a little bit about it last time we were here. That observation is that it's about around this time. It is tomorrow, 3 years since our bishop would have passed. The fact that I only think our hope is not to offend anybody, but it's because of God want me to say that before Brother Mike comes. When the news would have come to me, I immediately, on my way to our bishop room, I passed by him. And he had already left. I spoke with his son. He said, well, when he heard the news, he probably would have gone. And when I reached to the home, I didn't see Brother Mike. But afterwards, when we were talking, Brother Mike made some statement, and he is just living true to form. And I believe God wanted that to happen. And this is something that I could work with Brother Mike, say that he is going to be there, and God would have taken him in everything. We noticed that even in the way when I sat on the back, Brother Mike took that position. And that is what God will have us, that legacy that our Bishop would have Reverend Reverend James, and it is continuing. And God is no respecter of person. And this is what is happening with the church, and he would have, not only with the church, but also the adds to our organization. And in a way, I would have studied a little thing about organizational structures and how it operates. And God would not leave us comfortless. He would be with us even to the end of the world. And what we are getting in St. Bernard, I believe this should be extended to the entire organization, the structure, the line formation and the structured formation, how the word and how the church ought to operate. And God is with us. So without further ado, we bring the man of God. So as we continue to worship in St. Bernard, it be probably, let me say, second to none. That's how God would have it to be. So that the organization itself will understand that God is in charge. And what a wonderful day to talk about that resurrected Lord who would have said that all power is given unto him. So the church is moving forward ever, backward never. So we give God praise this morning, brother.
Thank you, Pastor Piper, for introducing me to membership in the saints of God. You know, as I say, saint of God, that brings me to the point that I always thought, before God granted me the privilege to be more knowledgeable about his word. I always thought a saint had a particular form to take on before, or a person had a particular spiritual form to take on before you become a saint. You know, I didn't know that a saint was a follower or believer in Christ. Well, you know that all the time I think in heaven, as somebody had to reach a particular standard to be a saint. And yeah, sometimes if you don't know, you start to go in the form of angel, and especially where the religious denomination took it and said, say this and say that. And not only that, they started to pray to people like yourself as well. Not all. Saint George. So if you didn't know before, that is why it behoves us as children of God to walk circumspect, because you are a saint of God. You wouldn't become a saint when you die. You ought to acquire sainthood here. And if I were to add anything to what Pastor Piper was saying, all I want to remember was that Christ does not fall back on his word. And our reverend who was here and left us around this time, he was given the privilege to know what our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the power of the resurrection, the dialogue of the resurrection time. That's all? Just 1 week after the resurrection. Resurrection night?
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
That's right.
Our God is awesome. When God make a promise to you, and Reverend James always said, I know you know I have a lot of questions to ask.
Yeah.
I have a lot of questions to ask. And when I reach there, he said, you know, I have plenty of time on my hand. He says, so I'm going to spend my first few years asking God the questions that man can't answer. God always sends a message or what we call guarantees for his word. That's all? So he took our reverend. He said, well, you have to, he said, you're always preaching resurrection. He said, I will show you. I'll give you an early experience of how this. And so instead of mourning, we bring about a sort of, it brings about a sort of joy in our heart to know that our dear reverend labored faithfully, expecting that Christ would call him one day. And he got that call around the time. His labor certainly was not in vain. If I were to get to the scripture this morning, let me greet those of you who came in late, or came in at the time you came in, but I don't want to make you feel that you're late. Once you get to the house of God, and if you're there for Jesus' sake, and then we say the benediction after that, that is sufficient for us still to save you and save somebody when you walk on the door as well. Jesus said. And it would be very easy for me this morning. My gospel has become very easy. As a matter of fact, when I finish guaranteeing you that God is true, Jesus Christ is true to form, I can afford most of it. Because when Sister Brianna finished singing, and then the choir finished singing,
yes,
it tells me that the message that I want to get over to you has already been told.
That's right.
So I am not here for you to admire how brilliant I am in speech. I am just here to put you in remembrance of the resurrection. If there's an account that have already been told, not by one, but by four of his disciples that we have documented here, another given account of it, but because time, one writer, when we get straight down in Revelation, he says it was possible. The works that Jesus did, the Bible, can't contain it. So we know that what I've been told is what is sufficient to save us. That's all? So if I am to deal with it, I will just talk about the goodness of the resurrection. And that word, good, I started to look at it. And it's our original word. But anytime you add N-E-double-S to a word, what it does to the word, it lends a favor of completeness. Nothing more to be done. It brings in the power factor in the word. So if you have good and you put next to it, nothing supersedes that. It reaches the pinnacle in which it should have, where the operating factor should be. So say that. So oftentimes I hear people say, I want to be the best I could be, or be better than I am. Those words are for local and competitive situations. That has no place when it comes, I want to be the best in Christ, or I want to be better. The book of Genesis says, and when God made heaven and the earth, and he finished, he said all that he had brought into existence, it was. You saw anything about better or best name? So I feel that when somebody in the New Testament say, good master, he say, hold on. None is good except. So I feel the word good and then goodness, because Christ would have had this to it, that's all. The resurrection would have been the. Resurrection would have bring the mystery, so the goodness of the resurrection. I want to look at, he is not here. He is not here. When we take the account, we see that the Marys, and apparently Mary was a name, was common, a household name in those times, because we have many Marys. So this is why when we study the Word of God, we have to look particularly of which one of the Mary that they were talking about. But in this case, we have two Mary and a Salome. We have three women. We see immediately, because of the information that is documented here, men was absent. That's all? So if I'm going with this account, it tells me for this early period of the lesson, the men was absent. And you're going to get that with the confirmation of Jesus Christ sending the message to through the Marys,
yes,
to tell them that I have been risen and I will meet them in Galilee. And not only that, but also tell Peter. So it tells me they were absent. My thing about this whole situation is that the goodness that the resurrection brought about. Number one, we know that before the Messiah came, the whole of Israel, which was really the people that the Messiah was really coming to, because the scripture says, I came to my own, and my own received me not, but to as many had received me, to them gave I power to become, even to them that call on my name. So we are clear that the resurrection brought about some the goodness that it was intended to bring. Of a short moment, the disciples was a bit, or the Marys were a bit disappointed. Because you could imagine the, and it had to be that they were accustomed doing for the dead what they was going to do for Jesus. Because you had to know what you had to know in order for the body to remain in the condition that you wanted to remain in, you have what we call embalming, putting the spices so that it would not break down as fast as we wanted to. Because I believe the Mary was saying, somehow in their heart, they believe that if we keep this body intact, and even though the 3 days passed and he didn't raise us, he said he would, if the body stayed, sometime that spirit, sometime Jesus will get up. So it is pertinent for us to preserve the body. But my God, when he gives a guarantee, he gives a guarantee. And it is important to search the scripture. When you search the scripture, things become more clear. One of the things I observed, remember the other morning, Good Friday morning, I was telling you, 9 o'clock in the morning, and I took it from 12 o'clock. Well, mother, I'm going to go a step further because it's on point. Christ said 3 days in the grave, and it is on point. So when he gave up the ghost, 3 o'clock in the afternoon, they didn't take him down until, because remember the Sabbath would have been approaching. And it was the custom that they could not leave a dead corpse around the place because that would have been an abomination to the religious sect. So they had to get that corpse done. So between 4 o'clock and 6 o'clock, that body went in the tomb. So in between 4 o'clock and 6 o'clock, and I tell you it would be a 12-hour period, we did not deliver 24 hours. So let us say 4. From 4 to 4 in the morning is 12 hours. From 4 that morning to 4 the next evening will be the next 12 hours. And from 4 that evening to the previous morning, very early in the morning, while it was yet dark. So we get 3 12-hour period, which was literally considered a day in that time. We're not using the 24-hour period at all. And if they check in from 6 o'clock, well, then it brings it more to the point, because while the sun was yet. So you see, Brother Judge, the evidence you can't get away from. So if I, from my research, could, with the help of the Holy Spirit, could bring this to the point where we have no other choice but to believe in the resurrection, well then I could dispel to you that the resurrection is real and there's a goodness in the resurrection. Mary and they reached to the tomb. And expecting to go in and meet Jesus in the form that he was placed therein was momentarily disappointed. When they look in, instead of seeing Jesus and preparing But remember, they had the experience with Lazarus, so they would have known. They themselves said, Lord, by this time, so they would have known if the body wasn't taken care properly of, it would have started to break down. So, when they reached, they didn't see it. But I wonder what was going through their mind. There was a short discussion. So you see, they didn't take into account. These women were so, their mind was so taken up in preserving the legacy or the prophecy that Christ says he will rail again on the third day. They wasn't thinking about the obstacles that they would meet. They met one obstacle and they was thinking within themselves. And they watch up. Oh, but we are no man here, right? Who is going to roll the stone away? Question. They didn't know. One passage of scripture says, eyes have not seen, nor ears heard, nor have it entered into the heart of man what I have in store. So if I take that and put it in the context, what I've already put in place, plans. Somebody tell me it's a large stone. Somebody tell me it was a very great stone. So by human definition, assure those women. The goodness in the resurrection is that the stone, provision for the great stone, was already made long before the Marys decided to reach in. What the Marys and they didn't cater for to is that from the time Jesus gave up the ghost, that body only looked like a body. Remember, he said, mortal shall put on immortality. And so? So it was not just the body of Jesus lying there. Jesus was lying there in his immortal state. How do I know that? How do I know that? When Mary met Jesus, another Mary again, met Jesus on the way, Rabboni, he said, Mary, is it you? Touch me not, for I am not yet ascended unto my Father. Yeah. That is how I know that that body could not be touched with corrupted hands. That body was claimed by our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ himself. So I'll put me down to sleep. And when I have had sufficient rest, I don't want nobody to say that they assisted me in coming out from the tomb. You see why God had us to put the plans in place for the stone to be rolled away. No human being could claim, had it not been for me, or my assistance or intervention, Christ would have still been in the grave. So provision was already made. So the angel that sat, a watchman making sure that nobody had come there to claim no false city, None. You know how much falsity he have written about what, how the, it went down and how. I think God sent an angel, place him there to take record. So all they were required to do is to do what they was instructed to do. Sometimes we get it mixed up, you know. We get instruction and the instruction is clear. But we feel because we want to impress somebody, we have to add. And then you add a little, you have to add a little and a little and a little, and, you, and just now you contaminate the whole thing. So God was making sure that the resurrection remained in its good form. Nothing to remain, nothing to replace good. If God say everything that I make was good, where this better and best come out from? Competition, mother. So Satan, when he was up there, began to thought, to think, I am equal or better than God. That's all. You see where the word better come out from? And if by chance he give me a chance to act, because that is what he was clamoring for. All of us are in heavenly space together. Why not give me a chance to sit on your throne? My throne I will not give to another.
Yes, sir.
Like what the Bible says. The Bible says, I will not give it to another. So we know that it has some clamoring for supremacy. And Satan thought within himself that if I get a chance, I'll be better than God. You hear? I will establish the throne above the throne of Almighty God. Satan said that. If I get a chance, I will establish my kingdom above his own. But he didn't know that Christ, who was in the beginning with God, he also was there, you know. He also was there from the beginning of time, you know. Beginning of time. Somebody said, I saw Satan cast down from heaven as lightning. Yeah. Mary and the disappointed. Nobody to roll the stone away. Now the word of comfort will come. He is not here. You see, the resurrection bring about some, and I tell you about the goodness of the resurrection. What about one of the goodness is guaranteed. So the guarantee that Christ had given them in the prophecy when he was preaching was that I will destroy this temple and in 3 days time. Fulfillment of statement or fulfillment of prophecy take place on resurrection morning. You see the goodness of the resurrection? A guarantee. So when they reach there and they look inside and they didn't see him, mortal will start to think somebody stole our Lord. Because remember, the word on the ground was that we can't let nobody know that Jesus Christ have risen as he said. It's as he said. So the Roman soldiers said, the chief commander said, if you are to pay some people to say while we sleep,
yes,
the disciples came,
yes,
and stole his body,
yes,
you better get that in operation one time.
Mm-hmm.
Because this Jesus business, we can't allow this resurrection business to take place, because it's about to bring about some goodness that the whole world will benefit from. to pay them and let them let that stay there. But somebody tell me, no grave can hold his body down. You see, what they didn't cater for is the resurrection power. Christ didn't reveal that in his whole ministry in the Palestine course, he didn't reveal that secret unto them as yet. He gave a little demonstration so that man would understand that. I tell all you all to raise up. When Lazarus died, that was a preview that if I could raise this man, I could raise myself. Feel God is looking, but yes, God always give you an insight into what he's doing in us. But sometimes we are so clouded with our judgment and interpretation that we miss the purpose of God giving us an opportunity to understand or take a peek into how he does operate. So Lazarus was an example telling them, and Jesus Christ himself said it, Lord, I know you hear me always, but not for me, but for these that stand around that they may believe that you have the power to do all things. You hear that? So Christ was setting the stage for his disciples to believe that when he tell them, I am the resurrection and the life. No man take my life from me. I lay down my life for myself. Nobody else. And when I'm ready, I will pick it up again. The goodness in the resurrection. Go and tell my disciples and tell Peter. Know why? He singled Peter. Because Peter was told by Jesus Christ before Christ went to the cross, Satan have a desire to sift you as wheat, but I will pray to the Father. I will pray for you.
Oh, yeah.
And when you are converted, your strength is broken. That is why he knew that Peter would deny him, not so? But Peter was adding on top of denial, telling Jesus Christ, none of the, remember Jesus Christ was prophesying his death. So it was the devil getting in Peter to cloud the information of the resurrection.
Yeah.
We couldn't be talking about the resurrection this morning if Peter didn't get through that statement and Satan did get the people and them to keep my Lord and your Lord alive. We won't be talking about the guarantee and we won't be talking about the goodness of the resurrection. So Peter tell Christ, be it far from thee, that could never happen to you. Christ already told him, why get behind me, Satan? That is when he was called a Satan. So sometimes, what we ought to do is that we could be members and followers in the Church of Christ and we are converted. Peter was preaching the word long ago. But when the time came, we would know that he was just up to that time as a follower. He was bringing the word, but he was not converted.
Don't do at all times.
Only when Christ prayed for Peter. Remember, when all that finished and he was converted. When he was converted, who do men say that I am?
Yeah.
You see what conversion does do? That is what the goodness in the resurrection. That's why that is what it does. Light up your intellect where spirituality is concerned, and it brings the truth to light. Who do men say that I am? And as fast as he used to talk, because he was quick to speak and he was quick to act as well. Remember with the soldiers, when they hold Jesus in the garden, Peter, I don't need, you see what I tell you? God had already put things in place. Nobody must be able to come and say that they assist me to get away from what I must go through. I have my eye on a prize. I know the only way for I to prove to the world and for the world to believe what I have been saying all the time is when I pass through the dark valley and shadow of death, go into hell, take the keys of death and hell from Satan, and rise triumphantly. That is the only sign that my work will be ended. But here Peter coming to join with some of those naysayers that the resurrection had already gone. That a doctrine in Paul and that time, in Peter, when Peter, because Paul came in late, in Peter at the time, they said, you have a doctrine that the resurrection had already taken place. So you had some of the followers of the Christian movement was saying, Christ said, going and dead again, because he resurrected. And that was a false doctrine. So when Peter come and compound that statement, come and make that statement, he had also the Satan in getting him to say that. So he was joining the club as well. So he said, When you are converted, strengthen your brother. So it's not everybody you see sitting down in the church. And what shall teachers do? Not everybody you see on the altar here is converted. You know? Some of us, we have good intellectual skills. And when we read, certain information stay with us. And because God grants us the power of speech and the ability to put over things, we could sound good at times. But you have to start to look to see in the behavioral pattern if they are converted. God, Jesus Christ was looking for that. And when he realized Peter was following and I will convert you myself. And when he was converted, here Jesus. When Peter answered the question, thou art the Christ. That's what we want to know, not so? Jesus Christ wanted to get out among the messages that one of the messages that he was sending, that I am not just Jesus, but I am in the perfected state, which is Christ. I am now perfected all things. Jesus Christ wanted to get on that statement because he knew Jesus already. So he wanted to get on the Christ part. I am the perfecter. So when Peter burst that, when the Holy Spirit revealed, you hear what Jesus said? Flesh and blood did not reveal this unto you, but my Father. And upon this belief, we say rock. He used the word rock there because he wanted something solid to place that belief on. So he used the stone as a metaphor. You understand? I'm going to rest it on top this belief, on top this truth. And the gates, we had told you the other morning, Christ went down and when Satan hear the rattling of the gates with Jesus' foot movements, he said, who is that outside there? The Lord. Oh, yes, come on! Ah, boy. Victory is mine. I come to tell you that I come to release all those people that are mine. I come for what is mine. You have to live good enough. because Jesus will come for us one of these days in resurrection, tells me that Jesus Christ alone is not, because he did it with Lazarus. He did it with himself one of these days. Oh Lord. I could imagine Reverend James waiting. Whether he could have a resurrection for us.
Perishable food.
Stand in storm, it will not be long. We're going to anchor by and by. Resurrection day coming for us today, huh?
Yes.
Desert Jesus! So, the angel was sent to roll the stone away. Mother, they're going to send some spiritual grave diggers. God is going to send some spiritual grave diggers that we can't see with our natural eyes. Right now, if you want a body to do further autopsy on, we call it exhuming the body. That's all. You're going to go down and you're going to get the necessary people to go in the cemetery and you're going to take them back out for the pathologist to further conclude or to make an announcement of, well, probably I missed something. Let me see if I find something. Nobody didn't have to do with that with my Jesus and your Jesus. Jesus do his own exhumation. He came out for himself. No back home, he had to go. As a matter of fact, I'm sending you, Michael, get down there. Roll that stone away for me. When them give and them come back, I have a message to send in Galilee that I want those fellas to know. Them fellas and them going back to where they were doing it. Because they lose hope. They lose hope. But they didn't know that the resurrection had some goodness in it, and that if Jesus Christ said, if I be lifted up and all men unto me. That's the guarantee in the resurrection, that the goodness in the resurrection. How come we could not have want that to happen? As much as we want to cry down the place that Jesus died, and some of us like to stay in that mode of being beaten with the whip, and I could imagine how the whip take it to a glad. I couldn't take that, so I'm glad it had someone. If it is that you are sentence have been passed on you for some crime committed, and your surely punishment will weigh down on your mortal frame, and somebody just was to appear out of the shadow and say, my honor, I plead in this man's behalf, I will take the punishment. And well, in this case, it's punishment. I'll take the punishment for him. So let us say, was he kept
alive? Excuse me, it's not working.
You wouldn't be glad?
Yeah, it's not working.
I'm telling you.
I'm going to check the tickets.
I am so happy that Jesus Christ brought about the goodness in the resurrection. I didn't have to think about getting those spices and all them kind of business. Mary Zandi was giving a message. Go and tell them. Go and tell them, just as I said, guarantee, that's all. Confirmation. New hope. New aspirations.
That's right.
New authority. The church after that got a new authority after the resurrection. Because remember, they had was to hide. When Jesus Christ was arrested, who followed from afar?
Yes.
They was hiding. That's what literally the men went into hiding. Yes. But Jesus, who have the all-seeing eyes, stood in the grave, in the tomb, and knew where they were. Because they won't all Galileans, but they converge in one place. That's all. Why them fellas okay for me? Let me go down so and hide. And Galilee has a sort of security place there for us. We'll stay down there until things cool down. Jesus Christ, when you wake up from sleep, he tell the angel, hear what them. I give you a message to give them girls. Come here, them girls, come here, just now. Because Jesus Christ knew everything. The Bible says very early in the morning, just as Jesus Christ said, you will wake up.
Yeah,
very early in the morning. Men like to sleep late, women just get up early. Had it not been for the Marys and the plan of Almighty God. So I can't even the plan of Almighty God. But we must give kudos. Where kudos is due. Had it not been for them, those fellas would have had to wait until some strange thing happened. Well, they would have just been like the two fellas on the road of Emmaus, not so?
Yeah.
So then they would have been without information. I hear them. What is going on? Are you going to hear something strange happening? How they killed that Jesus and all that? Good conversation, you know? And Jesus joined the conversation. What are they talking about, the boy? Oh, you're a stranger here. You are just come out. And no, it's my Jesus that take up the body from the grave and start to walk the earth. But he was walking in his glorified state. That's all. He was walking. Just imagine. Jesus Christ now left the tomb and walking in his glorified state. How do I know that? The two men on the road of Emmaus, when the conversation was ended and Jesus left them.
Yeah.
They said he didn't tell him our heart burn within us. Like what the resurrection does do.
Yes.
It brings about a burning. Somebody say, I have a burning. I have a burning.
Yeah.
I have a burning in my soul. When my heart is overflow and I don't know where to go, I have a burning in my soul. That's what the resurrection does, the goodness of the resurrection. And Christ, when he sent and the time came, he went and he met them. My God and your God doesn't need any keys. Because remember, he went down in hell and he already had the keys.
Oh, yeah.
He had the master key. Those fellas behind locked doors, contemplating on what we will do. Jesus invited himself through the door.
Yeah.
Jesus said, no, they didn't hear when no door opened, brother. Like what the resurrection does, the power of the resurrection, it grants you a new, you have to learn new power, grants us a new power. That hope that we didn't have before the resurrection, this hope that will lift this mortal body out of this state, that is the goodness that the resurrection brought about. Somebody say mortal shall put on immortality. Huh? So I don't know that I am sorry about the resurrection. Christian, have a new hope. The resurrection brought about the goodness of the resurrection, brought about a new hope. Remember the scripture say, those that sat in the region of darkness saw a great light. That's what the resurrection does. That's why we as Christians come here today to celebrate the resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We come in gratitude for his goodness. That is why we appear here, we come here, because we just want to come here and tradition say we must be here. When you leave in your home, you must leave home with the purpose, but for the resurrection. I am grateful for, and that is why we have to live a resurrected life. Not so? Always mindful that Jesus Christ said he will do. He did it. When you get in the room, them fellas and them, all kind of business going on there. But Jesus did something strange there. Because nobody in its glorified state, nobody could have recognized it. So when you reach it inside there, he did something that he did. The last thing he did with them, he do it over. What was that? He broke the bread so that they will be able to recognize through the action. This was the last action we saw the Christ did before he left us. And look just how he was breaking it before he went to the grave. Look, the action remains undisturbed. Same action. So they recognize him by the way he broke the bread. And then the resurrection also brought about a new hope. Is it I? It is I. Be not afraid. When that door opened, just saw them inside there and a fella come in. You remember they was hiding from the Romans. So that if somebody coming inside there and you recognize him in his glory, because all Jews, their apparel and the way they used to dress, if you keep the same pattern and thing, you can't tell one from another. So Jesus, in his form that he went in, remember, they couldn't know that he was in his glorified body. He had to tell them, trust me not, I am not as. And when he gave the authority to touch, that is when he took off. He took off his glorified body. Rested there. Hold on. I won't call you. Because this boy wasn't there. Thomas. Thomas was not there, not so?
Yeah.
So Thomas joined them after. He came in after. And Thomas, when they tell Thomas, hey, Jesus inside there, you know. He saw them talking foolishness. He said, I don't want to hear that old talk because. And you see me? Unless I see for myself. And he didn't only say that enough. He said, I want to see Jesus for myself. But my Jesus has always go one step further than you want him to go. He said, Thomas, come. Come. When Jesus called him by the name, he said, come. He said, feel me. He said, you recognize anything here that will cause you to continue to doubt? Thomas said, hey Lord, I believe. He said, all right, take your finger, reach your finger. And put it inside, in the womb. And Thomas cried out, once I was blind, but now I can see the light of the world. So Christian friends, we have what we call the goodness of the resurrection. We have new hope. We have new standard. We have a new Jesus. Because that he was now from his old form, the rabbi that we know that used to walk Palestine coast, was now in his glorified state and now representing the Christian movement in his glorified body. Then we had another hope.
Tell you.
When he was going back to heaven, put back on his glorified body, going back to heaven. Amen. That is for us, Madam Asli, no. Amen of Galilee, why stand the gazing? This same Jesus that you see going up will come again in like manner, new hope again, Mother.
Yes.
See the goodness of the resurrection? See the goodness of the resurrection. So, we couldn't stay at good. We couldn't say, God say, all things have been good. But when Jesus complete the task, they add N-E-S to it, meaning nothing else could be done. A completed mission. Mission completed. The subject was taken up, which was the devil. The subject was taken up, which was the devil, and put him to shame. Because the whole world was depending on these people to liberate them. Jesus come by dying for you and for I, and he paid the price, rose from the dead, and now we have a new hope. We are thankful to Almighty God today for his Son Jesus Christ, and I want to encourage you to continue. I hope these words that was brought to you today will empower and embolden you to further sink yourself in Christ and know Christ better than you know him now. Because most of us operating on what people tell us about Christ. And they give us some unnecessary burden to toss around with them. If Christ tell me who I set free is free indeed, freedom comes without no attachment. You're giving me a set of old. Christ had wants to tell them this, this kind of policy. You're laying a binding heavy burden upon those people that you yourself don't carry one finger. So he give us the authority. Anything that does not make you and motivate your spiritual ability or make you better spiritually, drop that. It brings nothing to the table. Christ had already paid the price. The resurrection, when the resurrection was completed, that was it. It was over. All we have to do is believe. To as many as believe, to them I give power to become God. Where you, anybody could give you anything to make you a believer. Anybody could pin any tradition on you to make you a better believer. The Bible says all you have to do is believe, and I will give you the power. No one of power from no man. So all them traditional foolishness, drop it off. I'm glad we coming out from the veil. You're bringing me here, not coming back again. Because I get to understand Jesus to get up. As a matter of fact, we should bring it to 6 o'clock because Jesus determined very early in the morning. I wonder why they went to 12 o'clock and not 6 o'clock. Apparently they didn't read that. Very early in the morning, the matter was by the graveside. So you didn't want to go with the matters them. So the Marys and them to wake up Jesus. You're bringing me here 12 o'clock in the day. And you know, a lot of people still have plenty of problem with that. You know the fee because we bring the service to 10 or move it from 12. I'll be declaring spirituality from that. Well, I wish those of you who doesn't understand, I wish you well. But Christ wakes up early in the morning. And he, as a matter of fact, somebody say he don't sleep at all. His eyes is moving to and fro and watching every movement that we make. So it doesn't matter what time we come and worship Christ. The thing about it is, the resurrection was brought about and we are now standing, waiting. I just anticipating. I just say like Reverend James. I say like Reverend James. I know one of these days, Christ will come for me. I want to be in a state of readiness. And when you come, I ain't have to drop off. I ain't have to run to drop off nothing. I want to be ready. As my old pastor, my pastor James gone, I knew he was ready. Because I could tell you, I spoke to him this Saturday evening before he died. And he was prepared. The last thing he told me before Mass, when I'm asking him, I offered me to leave the doctor. But I might, we will have to talk, eh? That's what he told. Well, you was witness to that. And I, not because he's sleeping, and I say sleeping, he's only asleep. Oh, yeah. Not because he's sleeping, I have a pin thing on where he tell me. I have witness. Christ always had a witness anywhere you go. Mother Maslin was here and her daughter-in-law. Yes. He said, Brother Mike, remember we had a chat. That was the last conversation we had. I was about 20 to 6, and Madam Marcel left up there and she went home. And when she called me, 4 o'clock in the morning, she told me, James, he didn't come through, you know, right? But he experienced, God did a new thing, eh? He took one of our own and gave him an experience of the resurrection. And we thank God for that, and we thank God for him leading us in the way that he led us, and maybe say, that we aspire to keep the legacy that he left. Those that are not up to the standard yet, we trust Almighty God that you will know that there was a legacy that was left here by Reverend James and Reverend Richardson. We want to continue that. God bless you.
In the morning.
In the morning.
Sing and we will close in prayer, but just one will it be message itself remind us if we will see confirming in the fourth chapter of Ephesians. And if we will just the verse 12 verse say, for the perfection of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. And that's the resurrected Jesus, not what he came for. Because when you understand, when you read that, it says that the same one who went down and the same one who came up and gave authority and gave some authority to some pastors, some deacons, and whatnot, and some of the 12 was confirming is for the edification of the church. And so we don't have those wood coming to us on this resurrection morning, as it were, so that we'll be a better people, a better ready, as we say, that readiness. The last words of our minister this morning was saying that we want to be in that readiness when he comes in the morning. So could we stand and sing this morning? In charge to keep Christ, have we gone to glorify? In charge to keep Christ. Sweet fellowship, Lord, we pray that the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, rest and remain with us. So as we leave, Lord, as that temper, he doesn't like what has happened, he's going to come in all forms and fashion. But we pray that your Holy Spirit, your constant guide, will continue to operate within us, so that when he sees us, we will be able to shout and we'll be able to let him know that he has no doing power. So we pray this morning that your Holy Spirit bless us. You are with us in the praying, in the singing, in the ministering of the word. Lord, and as you have blessed the word to your heart, it may be a means of comforting us, a means of strengthening us, a means of making us that better people. But when you come in the morning in all your glory and all your anointing, we will have fellowship with you. Because so we will know each other when that mist is being rolled away. So even, Lord, from then to now, we continue to give you thanks and honor and glory. Even on this time when you would have rose from that grave, when you would have said, oh, death, where is thy sting, oh, grave, where is the victory? And you rose triumphantly. Not only that, but you said that all power is given unto you in heaven and in the blessed church, Lord. You know the hearts of everyone this morning. And we pray, oh God, that you minister your love and your anointing and bring us into that peace which passes all understanding. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ,
the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit of
God, rest and abide with us all and forevermore.
Amen.
The Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, and so it shall be, all the Lord then.
So this is St. Luke Independent Baptist Church. They are having their baptismal service on next two Saturdays. Where is it? Yes, on April the 14th. Yes, so they will be having their baptismal service on April 14th. That's the second Sunday of April. And the revival services will commence from Wednesday the 10th to Friday the 12th of April at 7 p.m. nightly. Also, there will be a robing ceremony on the Friday night at Setuk. That's the robing of Pastor Chance, that new newly ordained pastor who is across there at St. Luke. They will be meeting at 8 a.m. at the for the baptism on this Sunday. They will be meeting at 8 a.m. at McNish Road. That is right down the hill by Pastor Jackson, where Mount Rose and so usually baptized. It's right down there. So that's for 8 o'clock on the 14th of April. Let me say one time, let us try and make some arrangements to go to the robing on the Friday night, as long as Brother Curtis is available. Make it at the on the Friday night, which will be the 12th. This is very selfish of me because I will not be able to go to the baptism. That's the only reason why I'm saying let's try to do the robing on the Friday night. So Wednesday we have prayer meeting. Good. So if I'm there, praise the Lord. If I'm not there, Wednesday will be my birthday, God's willing. So if you don't see me there, let me say like the long time people, I'll be there spirit. Okay, so you know birthdays already don't really keep me back from doing God's work. You know that. You know that. But my daughter will be here from tomorrow, please.
Praise God.
So it's just for a few days. So you know.
Yeah.
We don't know what's going on yet, but in the name of Jesus, I trust that I live to see the day and I want to just enjoy the day. Okay? Did I have something else? Right. So I think that was it. Also, as I'm on my feet, is there anyone and anybody or bodies in this congregation who would like to be a part of the marathon for the health seminar? You remember to announce that? Right. So we have the health seminar coming up on July 27th. But we know it's a little way off, but they are trying to organize the program. So they would like to know, Sister Christy? okay. All right, so they would like to know if, I just called your name, you know, they would like to know if there's anybody. Even I can ask Hezekiah, Hezekiah might be able to go walk from 6 o'clock, right? So there's that marathon, so think about it. This is about smiling, so she probably wants to go and walk. You never know, okay? I don't think after today we wouldn't speak about the conference anymore, because I believe whoever wanted to go will have indicated by now. One other sister indicated that she wants to go, so that has made me up to now not registered yet. I have to register today so that I can not have to pay extra money. Okay, so I'll be doing my registration today. Another sister from the church, she will be going along with me. So we give God thanks for that. So God bless us all. And Jackie, nice to see you again. Jackie, I don't know how many of you all would have known Jackie Gibbs. Maybe not many of you all. The older set of people, which is what? Brother Curtis? Well, Sister Joyce? But Brother Peter from way back. Tony, you know people? So that is, you know, Sister Gibbs? Okay. But they were members long, long, long time when I was small. Small. I'm talking not to my child when I was small. Okay, so we give God thanks that Jackie is back, and I'm saying Jackie is back. Words are powerful. Jackie is back. We give God thanks for that. I saw Sister Paula's daughter made it today. God bless you. She's here today with us on this Resurrection Sunday. He is risen. He's alive, girl. Yes. Brianna, thank God that you made it home for the holiday. When everybody run into Tobago, I'm glad that you were able to come. So God bless you and enjoy your time with your family. God bless every one of you all. Everybody. I can't call everybody name, eh? But God bless everybody. And keep us in Jesus' name.
Everyone.
Yes.
Everyone.
That's already.
Comments.
Everyone.
Everyone.